anything.
Okay. Line it with my hands.
Solo de película pudo llegar a hablar con todas las estrellas de Shazam.
So out of curiosity, what's the most fun thing you've done on the press tour for Shazam? Just, you know, not to mind anybody's feelings or anything.
Well, it certainly wasn't jumping on a trampoline attached to large elastic ropes. No, that was pretty fun. Yeah. Although exhausting. That was far more tiring than I thought it was going to be.
I felt so good about myself, the fact that you got exhausted, you who work out 6 times a week. But let's get to something that I thought made me cry, that I thought that it's been the most fun for you. We saw a video on social media of you getting an amazing hug from a young one who was affected by
in Brazil. Yeah.
Did you ever, when you were, I mean, because the movie looks like it was so much fun to make, did you conceive that that was going to be an effect, that you were going to have that sort of impact on a young viewer?
Yeah, I mean, I've been doing all this long enough to know that celebrity, if you're blessed enough to work long enough and build a career that has people know you, they see you, that gives you celebrity, that gives you fame, that gives you platform, and people, whether you like it or not, put a lot of value into all of our platforms. Mm-hmm. So it was never lost on me, even prior to this, that I have a responsibility with that, and an honor that I get that, and the people give that to me and trust me with that, you know. So getting this job and knowing the potential reach for what it could be and what it could mean for a lot of kids, and as you've seen the film, all the representation that's in the movie, I'm just one part of that. The first thing I thought about was, holy crap, Halloween's going to be out of control.
Yeah.
And the rest of my life with every little boy or girl that comes up and yells Shazam. And I'm like, absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. So that moment, that moment in Brazil was a really, it was just a very sweet, she was a sweetheart of a girl who had, you know, drawn me just a really lovely picture.
No, but to give you credit, some people look at that as a sort of response, part of the job, but you were emotionally affected, so that really got me as well.
I'm a softie. I mean, you know, when you got a kid literally crying tears of joy because they're meeting you, and you, if that doesn't move you, I don't know.
Let's not dwell on
go
that.
Go to therapy. Yeah, I mean, you know, trust
but who
me.
Who was somebody, who was studio the first, not doesn't have to be a superhero, but who was, as a growing up, who was somebody that was your first hero that you kind of looked up to that would have gotten that reaction from you, a big hug if you saw him?
I mean, Super Mario, you know.
Really?
Not because he was a plumber, but because he could throw fire from his hands when he picked up a flower.
Yeah.
No. Although I really was. I was such a gamer when I was a kid. I mean, honestly, I probably saw myself more in all the video game characters that I was playing than anything else. I don't know who... This might sound strange, but I genuinely... Well, Tom Hanks has always been kind of an idol of mine in the acting world. But Forrest Gump, the character of Forrest Gump, and again, I know this might sound strange, was kind of a hero to me. But literally because I saw that movie, I was probably, I think I was 12 when I saw that movie. I cried my eyes out because I wanted him to be real. Mm. I wanted someone who was
like
so
that.
Pure,
like that
who loved so intensely and without guile, without deceit, and wasn't angry with other people, even when they treated him like garbage. Like, I was like, that's who I hope we can all endeavor to be, you know? And not as dumb as, you know, stupid as a stupid does. Because you in that moment where he asks Jenny about his kids.
There's emotional intelligence.
Oh, my gosh. Emotional intelligence, yes. Yeah.
All right. So what were you, I mean, I know you've probably gotten this like a thousand times, but what were you like as a teenager? Because you have that sort of non-jaded sort of access to that, you know, because I have 12-year-olds, and I'm seeing like both sides, that there's like, oh, I'm over it, and then there's that, oh my God, what is this happening?
Yeah.
So what were you like in those years?
I was, as much as I'd like to say I was cool, I was
not. That wasn't
not.
The question, though.
I was not, well, no, because I think the cool kid tends to be a little more like, you know, unaffected or whatever.
Yeah.
I was never that kid. Okay. I didn't understand what it meant to be cool, really. I just always thought, well, we just got to be us. We just got to go do the things that we like to do. And I was a total spaz. Since I was, you know, 4 to now, you know, I all I've done is try to entertain people. And I found theater early on, and I was a theater nerd. And I, you know, like, that's who I was. So I was always kind of in this world of imagination and fun, and I think being affected by things, because I love feeling joy and I love bringing joy. Yeah. Like, that's like my MO. So anything involving that is always gonna affect me in that way.
So how lucky are you that you connected with David? Because I feel he's probably on the same wavelength with you, because that's what I get from the movie. I get that you guys had fun making it and that you want us to have fun watching it. So gush a little bit about your director and how did that work?
David F. Sandberg is just such a tremendous guy and director. I'm so indebted to him and the people at New Line and Warner Brothers for trusting me with this role, because it's, you know, it's a lot and it could go sideways real fast, you know, all of a sudden like, what have we done? And maybe they are, I don't know, maybe no, behind closed doors, no, like, no, oh God. No. David, you know, I'm really proud of him. I mean, you know, we're roughly the same age. He just started directing, I mean, you know, being given these opportunities to direct in these large ways not too long ago. This is his third feature film. Mm-hmm. And that's a heck of a graduation, you know? And I think he did it so, so well, clearly blending so many different genres and tones and feels, and it looks really pretty, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, he, man, some great frames that he and Maxime built. And then on top of all of that, he gave me and Jack and Asher and really all of us a lot of room to play. He gave us a lot of leash. He gave me a lot of leash. And I used every bit of it, you know? And then he trusted me with it. And that meant the world.
So I think big is going to be used as a pointer, given you that you're a
of
Tom
course.
Hanks.
Yeah,
but I feel that you have a bigger acting challenge here that Tom Hanks had in that one. Because in big, you see the kid for 30 seconds in the beginning and 30 seconds in the end. But you have to sort of mind meld and the facets. So talk about that. Merging with Asher.
It is true. I mean, big Tom, it's mostly Tom.
Yeah.
It's, you know,
it's all
I think
Tom,
David
really.
Moscow was the young boy, I think. But yeah, he was the beginning and the end, the bookends.
Yeah.
And we do back and forth throughout the movie, which is also so much fun to be able to do. Asher, fortunately for him and unfortunately for us, was still being a rock star in his Disney show when we started making the movie. So the amount of rehearsal time that I wish we would have been able to get, which is, you know, what's the ideal? Months and months and months of, like, living in the same apartment and being like, hey, buddy, how do you eat your cereal? You know, like, we weren't able to really get all of that. But David and myself and Asher would, sat and worked through some scenes to get an idea of, like, where is his emotional journey going to be and where I can pick up and leave off and all that jazz. And just hanging out with Asher and his family, just breaking bread and getting to know the heart of the kid. And I'm so proud of him. I'm so proud of him and Jack and all of the kids in the movie and the adults. I'm proud of the adults, too. But, they are just really, again, just genuinely good kids and talented kids. And I just want to protect them from the crazy that I know, you know, will come on some level, you know. I say this, but, you know, kind of as a joke, but not a joke. Like, I I knew Asher and I were going to be okay when I realized that he basically is going to be the next Justin Timberlake, because I love Justin Timberlake. Like, if I could be anybody else, I'd be Justin Timberlake. Hey, JT. And Asher will be the next. Like, he's like the whole, like he's like
so
a pop star.
Basically,
I'm like,
you say
I'm
you...
like, why? I'm not, you're going to be twice as cool as me when you're my age. So that's the most unbelievable part of it, I think.
All right, sir. So I'll see you when you get the sequel for this. I'll leave you alone, but you got a gem of a movie and amazing job.
Thanks, brother.
Nice talking to you again.
You too.
All right,
too.
You
Thank
guys
you.
Have a good day.